again. Oh, the cans can do miracles. Just you wait and see. Believe me. Sailing takes me away to where I've always heard it. Just a dream in the wind that carries.
Welcome board to our 14th annual congress. OASA grows by the year. And we term this congress Leaping into the Future because of the obvious leap year connotation, with yesterday being leap year day.
We created a system which we use in optometry to mark up multifocals. And the system that I use, normally my optometry practice, I use the system by Essilor, which is an Essilor HMS system, which is a height measuring system.
I am making the stock eyes mostly, and I'm supplying to all over the world because I am helping. I want to help to provide the best one, best quality in the stock eyes, because normally in market available plastics and cold cures eyes. So I'm making the hot cure acrylic by hot cure acrylic PMA.
Presentation is digital irises. I would just like to look at something maybe a little bit new and innovative. Those of you who have been to the congresses abroad obviously have seen the digital irises.
So when I start seeing, thinking about a patient, it's always, I would tell these patients also, it's not for the moment, it's not for a mirror. What I do is for lifelong time.
Medications now and just now. Right now I'm going to talk about ocular allergies. And I want to give thanks to Dr. Dindar, who's a doctor in Johannesburg, for some of these slides. He's helped me tremendously with the presentation.
So the Dutch way part two. It's an old family business. I told before, my grandfather started it, and they make teeth.
This talk is the second on ocular complications that I'm talking on. This is the other half, and this is just on glaucoma, and it's really just the basics of glaucoma.
So today what I'm going to talk about is dry eye assessment in anophthalmic patients. Now, as we know, it's very easy if you've got an eye to assess for a dry eye. There are a number of tests available which you can use to assess whether a patient has got a dry eye or not.
You know, we started our OASA a while back, and the goals then were quite simple. We first wanted to try and bring the standards up together. We wanted to have a unified coding systems that we can claim from the medical aids. We had a few goals like that.
As you know, an optometrist by training, you haven't got all the fancy dental mechanic terms. So for me, it's, I learned from a lady called Ursula Strickfaden, who was a German ocularist, who I trained under for 2.5 years. And she always called it plaster of Paris.
Perfect. Look across and the other way. That's painting a pupil and iris button.
And we that don't really have an ophthalmologist to go to, or they don't have the finances to have surgery. So then we end up getting patients that really have quite problematic sockets, that you make the ocular prosthesis, but you don't really get that proper cosmetic appearance that you actually want.
And now leap into the future. Travel safe, all of you.
Thank you.
And it's now closed, the Congress, so we can go now. The course is over.
It's finished.
Mr. Worldwide to infinity, you know the roof on fire. We gon' boogie, oogie, oogie, jiggle, wiggle, and dance like the roof on fire. We gon' drink drinks and take shots until we fall out like the roof on fire. Now, baby, get my booty naked, take off all your clothes and light the roof on fire. Tell him, baby, 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 I'm on fire. I tell her, baby, 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 I'm a fireball.
sing.